I'm Sean Collins. I want to tell you what you need to know about a chemical called PCE, and that's short for perchloroethylene, sometimes also called tetrachloroethylene. Now, how is PCE used? Why do we even care about it? Well, first of all, PCE was historically used by dry cleaners. It was also used as what's called a degreaser, an industrial soap, if you will, to clean parts at certain plants. PCE is also something that can happen when TCE, a chemical called TCE, biodegrades. It loses a molecule and turns into PCE. And all of those then create potential hazards for human beings. How does PCE get into the environment? Well, at dry cleaners, as I just mentioned, it can be spilled or it can be dumped and left to sit there in the environment. Also at industry, when it's used as a cleaner, and usually this happened decades ago, but it was dumped into the ground or buried and left to sit there and winds up bleeding down through the soil and gets into the groundwater. Sometimes also you see PCE that was buried at landfills will also be able to bleed down through the bottom of the landfill and get into the groundwater. And when it gets into the groundwater, now we're talking about a real threat to human beings. People are exposed to PCE because the PCE in the groundwater comes up into their homes. If, for example, a home has a private well, that means that it gets its water directly from the groundwater below. And if that groundwater below is contaminated with PCE, that's what's coming out of the kitchen sink or the showerhead. Also, PCE comes into contact with human beings by a process called vapor intrusion. And that simply means that the PCE in the groundwater below the home can turn into a gas, a vapor, so to speak. And then that vapor comes back up through the soil and can slip into the breathing air of that home or business right up above the contaminated groundwater and can actually be in the air that people are breathing inside. Now, because PCE is colorless and odorless, people can be breathing it or drinking it or taking a shower in it and they don't know that they're coming into contact with PCE. So it's dangerous in that regard. Now, let's talk a little bit about the health information that's important for you to know about PCE. Most importantly, no safe level. There is no safe level of PCE. Also, our government agencies here in the United States say that it is a likely carcinogen, a likely cancer causer, most notably associated with cancers such as leukemia, non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, skin, lung, colon, and bladder cancer. In other words, it's a dangerous chemical, especially since there's no safe level. It disrupts the immune system and makes it more difficult for our bodies to process toxins. That's really the root of the problem when PCE gets inside the body. I should also add, and this is very important, PCE is especially dangerous to children because children's immune systems are not well developed. They're not nearly as mature as adults. They have more difficulty processing toxins. And that's why disrupting a child's immune system can be so much more dangerous than disrupting an adult's. So the bottom line of all of this with PCE is if it's in your home, in your neighborhood, or you even suspect it is, you need to take all steps you possibly can to separate your family from PCE. Now, what I've given you is just some bullet points, an overview. If you want more detail, you can go to my website, which is www.collinslaw.com, and click on the environmental blog, and there you'll see more information, more detailed information about PCE.